Hello, everyone, and welcome to the morning, the next morning after the June full strawberry moon, where we had a full moon fire circle last night down at the Cranberry Portage campground. It was a very special evening with friends, and I welcome you to join us next month in July. So this video is part of the 13 moons, the teachings from the grandmother moons, 13 of them throughout the month, and what we can sort of gain from this strawberry moon here in June. So welcome, and let's begin. So just to go over kind of quickly the moon phases, for those of you, this is the first video that you're seeing. We start off with our new moon when half the moon is in darkness, doesn't receive any light of the sun. And so for the new moon, the dark side of the moon is facing the earth, and we don't see anything. So this is a time of where we kind of gather back our strength and we sort of take it easy. We rest and we release after completing a moon cycle. And then every night, a little sliver of the light side of the moon starts turning towards the earth. And the moon starts its waxing process until it reaches its halfway point, half light, half dark, the quarter. And then finally, we reach the full moon where the half of the moon that is lit is facing the earth. And we see the moon in its fullness, which is happening right now. And as we went through the waxing process, we start to plant our seeds of intention, like what we hope to work on in the, you know, during this 28-day moon cycle. And when we get to the fullness, you know, this is where we celebrate the, you know, Our creative juices are flowing, right? The ebb and flow of the tides that are affected by the moon, they also affect us as well. So this is a time of expression. And then every night after the full moon, the moon starts, a little sliver of the dark side of the moon starts to come back, and we start into the waning process, into the where we kind of gather back our strength. And so now after we planted the seeds right after the new moon or the dark moon, the full moon is when they're, you know, flowering in their fullest. And then in the waning process, it's like we are like weeding our garden, and we're fertilizing our garden to make sure that we are making choices in our life to help, you know, nourish that growth. So this is our moon cycle. And so I really enjoy the power of ritual. Just becomes habit forming that, you know, I myself is a living thing, and the same with all of us living things, human beings, that we are of the earth. We are connected to the same cycles that affect all living things. So the moon cycle is one way in which we can stay connected. And so same thing, every one of these moons, we sort of start with like, what's the power, the teachings from it, and what this moon invites you to explore in your healing journey. And then we have sort of like a takeaway that, that we leave with. Okay. So when we look at the power of the full moons, you know, people have been staring up, so all different cultures have found the power in the full moons, and it's a chance for people to get together in community and connect. And so in terms of, that's why I really like the fire, full moon fire circles, right? Not only because it's a cycle, but because it's gathering that community. So that when we in the invitation here is for us to come home to ourselves. And when we put that commitment into our own healing journey, we actually start raising the vibrations and the energy of our whole collective human spirit. So this is why this is a really good practice. So that's why even these videos are great. Even though we're not, you know, together, you know, just through even watching on social media, or many of you connected with me that you were interested in coming into the full moon fire circle that we had last night, but couldn't attend. Just having that connection, connecting with me and our community here in Northern Manitoba, you're still being held in that sacred space. And that's a beautiful thing. So the moon teaches us to, you know, to not only just go within to do our own healing, but then to turn that love into acts of service and focus outward on what can I do to sort of, you know, help others and in the process empower myself. So let's, and there's, I like that little saying there at the bottom here, that these rituals, they help bring focus into our lives, kind of like a grounding, a centering, okay? So that we can give blessings and gratitude for having yet another moon cycle to evolve and grow. So let's continue. Okay. So I like using the teachings from that have been given to me through Indigenous people. Here's our 13 moons, and many First Nations use the back of a turtle to represent the lunar calendar. So the big scales in the middle, there's 13 of them, and they account for one of each of the moons, one per month. But then we have an extra one because, you know, there's a 28-day lunar cycle and our months are 31 days. So we have one extra blue moon in there. And that'll be this, this year it'll be in August. And then around the outside of the turtle shell, you have the 28 smaller scales to represent the 28 days in the lunar cycle. Okay, so for this month, oh, and by the way, I just put this link on here, and all these links will also be on the bottom of the of this YouTube. Zoom doesn't like it when I play music and talk. So I don't like to play background music because it kind of interferes with my recording. But here's the link of the playlist that that I would recommend. Okay, or feel free to listen to whatever you wish. Okay, so this moon here, we have, you know, we're on June 5th here, and it's the, and by the way, you can always, you know, focus on these moons, you know, 3 days before the full moon and 3 days after is the moon is still having a very powerful effect. So don't really worry if you, you know, it's, if you did this on June 4th or June 5th, the fact is that you're still doing the work is everything. Okay. So, for this moon here, here we are in June, and June is all about, enjoying this ripening, the birth and bloom of June. So I have some blooms here with me, and celebrating the dandelions, not as weeds, but as very important medicinal plants. So we're taking all this energy right now, and we're going to use that energy to help make some things happen. Take our intentions and put them into practice with creativity, or doing acts of self-love. And so in this sweet and spiritual time of this strawberry moon, we want to focus on indulging in pleasure, doing things that just bring you joy. So I want you to think about, as we go through this ritual, what brings you joy? And I want you to focus on trying to bring that into this moon cycle. And ripening and blooming also means that when we look you know, through the out at the world outward, to see the good, no matter how small it is, see the good things that are happening around us. Celebrate strawberry moon. You know, eat the berries. I don't have any strawberries here because we're just flowering right now, our strawberries. But as soon as they are out, you know, we are going to be making our magic moon tea here with the dandelions because we don't have strawberries yet. But if, as soon as you do, like these, you know, or eat salads or eat things that from nature that are nature's expression of this ripening phase. And don't forget to stop and take time to smell the flowers. And then what we want to do here as we approach the summer solstice, another very important in the yearly calendar here, wheel of the year, we want to reflect back at the growth that we've had since even the winter solstice or even the spring equinox. Okay, so winter solstice being that time of kind of hibernation when we were sitting in our dark phase doing our shadow work. We, rather than focusing all on things that, you know, haven't really come to be yet that we wanted, focus instead on how far you have come and how well you are doing, okay? How you are blooming. So our strawberry moon, same three kind of steps here. The first thing we're gonna do is prepare for our sacred space. And feel free at any time in this video if you want to pause it to get ready or pause it because, you know, I've asked some questions, if you wanna jot them down in your moon journal. So by all means. And then we're gonna go through the ritual. I like following ritual is kind of like habit forming. And I'm trying to show you like different elements of things to add, but again, like ritual, it's meaningful to you. So you have to do what feels good to you. And you know, feel free to change it up and find whatever works for you, okay? And then again, the focus on is kind of like, what is our takeaway as we go into the next 28 days? Okay, so let's prepare for our sacred space. Here's a big list of things suggested. I have a little quote there that really an altar is just you being present and being heart-centered. You are present and you are open to receive. That really is all you need. But if you wanted to, you can sort of see I have a collection of stuff. I sort of moved my videos to here in my kitchen island because in my office there's just not enough room. I need this big space here for creating the altar. So go ahead and have, you know, your strawberries. So I'm just going to grab my, I forgot to grab one of those. Okay. And, you know, so your fruit and, you know, I have some fresh blooms. I'm very fond right now of the dandelions. So I have them out and then you can have some other things like you have the candles or one candle. I threw in there some of the moon colors that, strawberry moon is represented by. So go ahead and use, if you want, like color therapy, use candles of those colors and crystals. If you want to have your crystals, there's the spiritual meanings from this month. So you can find crystals that sort of suit that as well. Salt is a good thing to have for your raise the vibrational energy. Okay. And then your journal and pen. So you have something to, some paper here for you to do some journaling. And maybe your journaling is on a piece of paper that you can burn afterwards. Those of you who really like the releasing ceremony. Okay. And then we're going to prepare. First of all, I like the magical moon tea to be kind of steeping. I love tea ceremonies. Anybody who's been with me in my fire circles, you know, it's always about representing the four elements in that magic moon tea. And that's what we That's what we did last night. And so I like to have the tea kind of like steeping throughout the whole ritual so that it's good and strong when we go to drink it. So there is sort of a list of things that you can include in your magic moon tea. So let's, before we start anything, let's prepare our sacred space. Put on something that you're comfortable in. So I put on a shirt that says plant, grow, bloom. I have on my leather amulet that was given to me by my yoga practice instructor with the amethyst in it that I always use to smudge. I have on a, I usually always have a talisman I wear, but this one's different. This was given to me. This is my my Sandy dog here, a picture of her and a little memorial on the back that I'm wearing right now as I'm, when we get into the cards, I found it very interesting because it was talking about love and opening up to new love. And I just lost my best friend. It was a very difficult time for me because I feel like I feel guilty that I wasn't there for her in the end because she ended up getting lost because she was, you know, partially blind and deaf. So she couldn't find her way home. And I felt so bad that I wasn't there for her in the very end, but we had gone through so much healing. She found me and I found her and we had gone through a healing journey together. So now I have a lovely new dog, Willow. She's right sleeping on the floor here. I'm opening up to new love. I still miss my old love like incredibly badly, but I wear it close to my heart. So I'm wearing what makes me feel good. And let's do our smudge. Whoa. Sorry. Can't see where my cursor is there. Let's go ahead and clear our space here. So I have a smudge bowl that I have up here at the front. We're going to light a smudge. Okay, and we'll smudge the area. Okay, and then we smudge ourselves, our eyes, so that we can see the beauty of the world, our ears, so that we can listen to others, breathe in the sacred medicines here, get it right inside our prana energy here, up over our heads, so that we can have clarity, but also to open our divine connections, so that we can ask our spirit guides to join us today. Open down to our throat so we can speak kindly of ourselves to others, our hearts so that we are open to receive, and just all the way down our chakras here into our, we're trying to tune into our intuition. So solar plexus, sacral, right all the way down to your feet so that you always remember what it's like to walk in somebody else's moccasins. And I'm just going to finish smudging everything here that we're going to be using tonight, including tarot cards and my flowers here that we're going to be making the magic moon tea out of. All right. So now that you have smudged, we want to smudge this space to cleanse it, remove all ill, bless it now, let love and light fill. Okay, so let's prepare our magic moon tea here. So I have, if you want to use one of these cups that have the infuser kind of built into it, or put the following into a cheesecloth and use it like that. So we're going to be taking our dandelions. Okay. And in our tea, so I would probably wash these first before putting it into your tea because there's lots of little ants out there. Okay. but I'm just doing this for demonstration because I've already have my moon tea prepared and it's already cooking right now. But you don't want to have any of this green on the back of the dandelion. Take that off. It's very bitter. So just sort of, and this is easiest to do when you first pick them. Okay, so I don't want the stalk. I'm not going to use that for this. Okay, just the flower, and then you can drop the flower into your infuser here. And I would pack this whole infuser full, or your cheesecloth full, like a good handful of packed dandelions. Now, if you have some strawberries, by all means, add that as well. And the longer you let it steep, the stronger it's going to be. Okay, so I have mine going, and I'm going to let that sit there. We're going to be using that tea later on. Okay, so let's prepare for our ritual here. So now that we have kind of an altar space set up here, we cleanse our space, we cleanse all that surrounds, we cleanse away any heavy sounds. So if sounds come in, just bring those into your ritual with you. Lightness comes and lightness breathes. Lightness is all around me. This sacred space is protected. This space is cleansed, and this space is ready for the new to begin. So I welcome you all to this sacred circle. We ask in our four directions, in the area of the east, where we have our winds, the winds slip ever so gracefully across the land, our air element. We turn our eyes to the east and we give high praises for the great spirits of air. We welcome you to our circle on this night when the moon is full and shining throughout the world. In the south, we have our fire element. And the last of the warming rays of the sun have just dropped below the horizon as we turn to the south, where the great fire spirits make their home. We give thanks for your attendance in our circle tonight, and we offer high thanks and praises for the gift of life that you have bestowed upon us. Keep our path illuminated as we move from place to place so that no harm or accident will fall our way. And in the west, the sound of moving water conjures up memories of things both beautiful and filled with adventure. And as we look towards the west, we are filled with a sense of comfort, joy, and protection. We honor the west for joining our circle and offering us the endless gift of cleansing waters, which generate our bodies, regenerate our bodies and our spirit. And in the north, our earth element, where the great spirits of earth make their homes, those who have traveled throughout the densest forests and across the highest mountains still have time to share their blessings to us. We give high praise for the many gifts and the teachings for the earth element for joining our circle tonight. And lastly, great goddess, great God, creator, use your own language here. With humility and great praise and honor, we present ourselves in our truest self. We are those who work the land and drive the herds. We are the servants, the messengers, the disciples, and the students. We are the kings and queens and lords of our own domains, but we are mere individuals. And yes, we are all a family. Together, you bring balance to the world, and the world smiles upon us. Thank you for attending the circle on our full strawberry moon. The circle has now been cast. And let us prepare ourselves for a meditation here. So finding yourself in a comfortable position. If you can see the full moon and lie underneath it, you know, by all means. If not, I just want you to bring that image into your mind's eye. Ground yourself by taking some slow, deep breaths in through the nose, out through the mouth. Breathing in, maybe you can still smell the sage or the smudge in the air. Breathe a nice deep breath in through the nose. Hard exhale through the mouth. Feel your shoulders drop. Give them a little wiggle to relax the body. Our second deep breath in. This one's for the mind. And as you exhale, just telling your mind that there's nowhere to go and nothing to do, but just to be in this moment. Our last deep breath in. As you exhale, push that energy down into your heart space so that we are feeling gratitude for this sacred circle time that we have right now and the fact that you are here. Allow your breathing to become more natural. I'd like you to relax and visualize yourself laying on a beach, listening to the sounds of the waves, looking up into the stars arching above you in the sky, and picture the huge moon brightening all your surroundings. You are the moonlight. You are glimmering on the water, part of the moon's halo, covering all the visible parts of the sky. So you lie here in the water, you feel it, harmony, relaxed. To exhale, release any worries, any thoughts that come into your mind, just simply exhale and release. I want you to concentrate on your skin, feeling that moonlight touching your skin and penetrating inside your body. Slightly warm, the sun's energy being transformed after reflecting off the moon. Every breath in, want you to breathe in more and more of this energy, this light. Breathe in this light and feel how it calms every cell of your body. How it recalibrates your inner flow. And how it unwrinkles your face and your skin as it completely relaxes. She continue to breathe in this loving moonlight until you feel your inner vessel is completely full. We ask our spirit guides to be with us now. We open up ourselves say you're in your own mind, your own prayers for the moon, dreams, release them to the universe. I'm open to the unfolding path and the synchronicity that flows through my world. Tell your spirit guides, I let go of what no longer serves me, and I'm open to what is. Please show me. I'm open to receive. I'm wholly rooted in my truth. Om Namo Narya. And if you want to, if you have a candle lit already, you can light yourself a bonfire outside. Any kind of fire. This actually is a moon of Sagittarius right now. So very much the fire element. And in the month of June, we have the summer solstice, which is the celebration of the sun at the longest day of the year. So the fire element is very strong right now. We also have fire divine masculine as well, with Father's Day coming up. The sun being, divine masculine, whereas moon is divine feminine. So a lot of work this month with fire. So simply light that candle, maybe choose the color of candle that's for our June month, like orange, yellow, or gold, something to pay homage to the sun. That's why I also like the dandelions with the yellow, orange color for the sun. And just let that flame burn any kind of negativity that may be floating around, and help us also with as we move into our journaling portion of the ritual. You can use that flame if you want to burn what you've written in a releasing ceremony, by all means. And by the way, just a reminder that we do share in community at an actual fire. So if you would like to be part of these rituals in person, just look for the next one coming up in July. So let's set our intentions today. And I want to try a little mindful eating exercise here with our strawberry. Now, I have an apple. You can use whatever you have on hand. I live in cranberry portage. I cannot just go simply to the store and pick up strawberries like many of you can, but I intend to do this later on when I'm going shopping later this afternoon. So let's set our intentions for today. So with our strawberries here, okay, before we move into our setting our intentions, let's just do this grounding activity to, before we ask kind of for prayers to sort of help us for assistance with spirit guides, it's always a good idea to, you know, first of all, to give your gratitude for creation. Okay, it's like having a friendship with creator. If we were a type of friend where we were just always asking, you know, like to give to us, and we didn't give anything back, that wouldn't be much of a friendship. So we're going to use our apple, or if you have a strawberry, for this here. So this strawberry is particularly good, or any kind of fruit, because this is the act, here's the biology teacher here, right? A result of sexual reproduction of the plant, right? The fruit is the result. So again, we have the result, the birthing with the divine masculine and the divine feminine coming together. So this is full of love, all the good fortunes and good medicines, vitamins and minerals from the plants are put into its fruit, whatever kind of fruit you have. So prosperity, fertility is what the fruit represents. So let's hold the fruit in our hands and think about this month was all about, you know, bringing joy and pleasure to our lives. So I want you to sort of think about where joy is present in your life. And if you're looking at your strawberry there, you can think about maybe times in your life when you went strawberry picking or you ate a strawberry, even if you don't have one here. Maybe you were with your grandparents and you have a very fond memory. Just acknowledging that we've already have experienced joy in our life. We already know what we want. And so when we manifest and set our intentions, we are just allowing what is already within us to grow. We're allowing that healing to grow, which a lot of people have issues with manifestations, where you just throw it out there to the universe that, you know, I want to be wealthy, I want $1 million, and it'll happen. And they say manifestations are a joke. But that's not really how manifestations work in my eyes. It's more you are paying homage, you are giving your energy, and energy flows where attention goes. So if you keep putting your attention to what you want to bring into your life, well, then the energy is going to flow with that. And then you're going to naturally start making choices that are in alignment with those, with what you want to bring into your life. So let's use this fruit, thinking about all the good times, maybe on a beautiful sunny day or with, you know, super good friends, you shared an apple with somebody you love. I want you to bring that into that fruit right now. And we accept our past and our future, but we let them go so that I may live fully present in this moment. And you can take a small bite of your fruit and just allow all of your senses to start opening up. The explosion of the fruit on your taste buds, the smell, the texture, maybe the sound when you took a bite. Okay, And we honor all aspects of this sacred being and our sacred being, our body, our mind, and our soul. And we want to attract abundant growth, just like this fruit represents. We want to bring change and creativity under the light of this full moon. And we invite all that is new and positive into our lives for the greater good. And if you have your piece of paper here, let's do a little, you know, giving thanks. You know, writing down what we are grateful for. And if you wanted to write it down on a piece of paper, and again, feel free to pause the video if you wanted to, you know, actually do this process. But here you can see, oops. Let me go back one. I was trying to find a way to get rid of that toolbar at the top, but it doesn't seem to want to go away. One nice thing to do if you do it on a piece of paper or maybe a colored piece of paper, writing down what you are thankful for, maybe a list of the memories. Remember what we shared with our apples, the events, the people, any things that have brought you joy in your life. Just free write on a piece of paper, you know, a little word splash or. And then if you want, one really nice thing to do with these words of gratitude, right? This is all your manifestations, what you want to bring into your life, how you felt in these past events that brought you joy. One neat little thing to do is to use that piece of paper to make an origami animal. And I chose one that was easy because some of us like me are a little spatially awareness challenged. And so this is an easy little fox that you can make with your gratitude piece of paper and just keep it maybe next to your bed or on your altar during this moon cycle. So we give thanks with open arms for all that has been. And I open for all that is flowing into my life and then comes from the unseen. So we're trusting and surrendering and giving thanks for our spirit guides who have our best wishes. And if you'd like to take a moment to, if you're still in the writing process, you can write down in your journal. Some questions to think about underneath this full moon as we sort of ignite this transformation here. We are bringing forth kind of like maybe what our struggles are. Now that we've given thanks, now we're doing like some of the asking, what we are requiring some assistance from. So, but we still want to keep it in their blossoming phase here. So rather than again focusing on what is not working in our lives, I want you to think about, since December, you know, what has been, you know, from the winter solstice, what has been sort of, and if those of you who journal, go back and do these readings back, what you were writing in the full moons back in the winter time. What has been building from you? You know, how have you grown since the winter solstice? Do you see growth in your life and the things that you were adding? Talking about back in the winter, do you feel more positive now? And one thing I'd just like to share is when we did meet at the fire, there were so many positive stories. Maybe summertime makes us feel more positive because we're getting all this vitamin D from the sun, and we tend to, those of you who are into the practice of Ayurveda, right? We tend to want to eat more cleanly, maybe more fruits and vegetables, so our digestive systems don't feel as sluggish like they do in the winter months when we're sort of eating more of the carbohydrates. There was a lot of positive stories, people feeling like very empowered. It was so uplifting to hear, as opposed to back in the winter solstice when we met, a lot more shadow work being done. And it was, you know, it was a hard time for a lot of people. So lots of growth. And, you know, what has been, after doing all this shadow work, what is, you know, culminating or growing for you now in this strawberry full moon? And with its fullness of the, you know, what is it at its height for you right now? So go ahead and pause if you want to sort of think about that. If you're still sort of at a loss, kind of what, you know, has been culminating for you, let's turn to the tarot cards to help get a little bit of insight on these questions. Okay, so we did the three card spread at the full moon ceremony, and this is what we're going to share. These were the cards that we pulled together. So remember the way these cards work when we pull the cards here. You can use any kind of divination tools to help illuminate or bring clarity to some of the questions that the grandmother moon is presenting. So crystals, I love tarot. I'm going to continue through this series of 13 moons using the Light Seer tarot deck. I will put the link to where to get this from in your in down below in the description. And the reason why I'm sort of using tarot throughout the 13 moons is because I've been following the teachings of this book called Tarot by the Moon by Victoria Constantino. And you can look for this on Amazon here. But this has been a very good book for using this particular divination tool. So we ask that, you know, the cards, that they sort of help shine this light. So I've been doing the same. I'm going to continue to do the same full moon spread, because what I'm also finding very helpful is looking at the cards from the month before and just even in 28 days, what has evolved. So that's why we're sort of having that consistency. So we ask these cards here to bring us clarity tonight to anything that the cards bring forward. We're just using to help shine a light. Please don't misrepresent what the cards mean, like to go quit your job or something like that. We're not using them in that purpose. I don't like to use cards for like definitive things like that, just merely to help shine a light to what is already the answers that are already in you, just helping bring those forward. So the cards for tonight, the first card, excuse me, I'm still choking on the apple that I took a bite of. Mindful eating is hard when you're making a video. So the first card here is kind of like the full moon. What is the teachings that this full moon is bringing forth to us? Last month, let me show you the card, first of all, from last month. And the card last month was the Seven of Pentacles. Okay. So if you look closely at this card, those of you don't even have to know about tarot cards, and just, this is why I love the Light Seer deck, in that the pictures are quite self-explanatory, that you can listen to your intuition just by looking at the cards. So do you see how he's putting his attention to helping culminate, to help that plant grow? We were just talking about that with manifestations, that energy will flow where attention goes. So if you are putting your energy and your attention into helping your mind, your body, your spirit grow, then that dedication to your daily sadhana, your daily self-care, look at the how well that plant is growing. It has a very solid root structure. Pentacles, by the way, is there's four suits in tarot. Again, why I love tarot, because I love following the indigenous teachings that were shared to me with the medicine wheel. So pentacles would be all about like that earth element, where you are the earth, your home, your finances, you're taking care of your body. And you can see how you're branching out as a result of putting all that in energy in. So that was last month. Okay, very positive card. And as a result of getting that solid root structure for you, okay, as a result, look where we're at in the month of June. Look where we're at in the month of June. There we go. The world, like probably one of the most positive cards in the tarot deck here. Look how wide open she is. Heart center. I personally kind of love this because her dress reminds me of the rainbow with the pride colors. This is June is Pride Month here, here. And what is the saying people, you know, for pride? Love is love. She is representing that love. It's showing that you are, look at the big circle there. The circle actually, if you look closely, is two snakes, two serpents, divine masculine, divine feminine, cycles, moon cycles. You've been putting the work in. We have elemental symbols that you're in balance with all of them, and your compass is pointing you on a journey down a path that is to your highest good. Your inner landscape is now merging with your outer reality, and good things are coming towards you. This is a time for joy, for abundance, to be heart-centered. And so with this card, I accept this is a gift of completion, and I ascend. She is rising to the new levels of awareness and the wholeness that I am love. That's what the full moon is saying. Wow. So that's what the full moon is saying on the outside, our external reality. The next two cards are kind of looking at our internal reality, our inner landscape. So the next card here that we pull is, in order to make room for growth, right, for new positive energy to come in, we still got to keep doing the work to clear out old energy, old behaviors or thought patterns that are not in alignment with us opening up like that. So what is it that we have to release? Last month in May, the card that came up in May, remember, it was the Hierophant upside down, which means it's in shadow. So that means it's something that we need to work on. So the Hierophant is somebody, look, he's grounded. He's sitting firm on the ground. He's open. He's got, you know, the chakra symbol even on his t-shirt there. His arms are open. He's welcoming you to your own healing journey. Those are your steps to your own enlightenment. And he's there to welcome you. But something is maybe holding you back, which is why the card was in reversed. You're not taking the steps, or maybe listening to voices that are casting a doubt on you. That was last month. Let's see where we're at for this month. This month, there we go. Again, in reverse. This month was the Ace of Cups. Cups, right? Emotionally full. The cup is half full. This is like our emotional, I'm sorry. Our emotional health here is in the cup. Now, the card is reversed, which means we got to work on this. Let me show you the card the other way around. It's kind of hard to look at it like that. Okay. Love this card. Okay. So these two cards kind of work well together. what is going to cause that world, that open heart center. Look how she has her divine feminine, divine masculine, both sides right at heart center. Remember when we come together in Anjali Mudra in Namaste position and we say, the spirit in me honors the spirit in you, the giving, receiving. Okay. The yin and the yang is all coming to focus there in her heart center. And it's beaming with light. So your capacity for love is expanding. Now, even when this card was in reverse and the cup was upside down, that cup was still full. So remember what we did when we went back to our apple is we have had times in our life when we experienced joy. We have. Yes, we've had dark times, but focus on what you have had and put your intention on the good that you have had. I remember how good that felt. And I want to achieve it again. That's that manifestation that we want to. So our heart, if we want to feel like our full moon wants us to feel, then we need to have our heart open and filled with love. Love for ourselves, for relationships with others. Okay, so again, looking at, remember, this is also very relevant for that duality there. Okay. Now, when we do this work and we honor divine masculine, divine feminine, remember masculine, I, as a female here, we're remembering that Father's Day is coming up this month. Okay. And we also have summer solstice, which is about the sun, again, divine masculine. And right now we're in the full moon, which is divine feminine. So we have a lot of celebrations of both of those divinities to make sure that they're in balance. So what is getting ready to emerge and to be received once we have this capacity to love expanded? What is going to happen? Now, last month, this was the card from last month. Okay. And this was, we were getting ready to birth something. Okay. So remember, this was our culmination. She was getting ready to birth, and it's a whole world. Again, when you heal yourself, you raise the overall collective of all human beings. And so that's what this, and there's the full moon there. You can see the moon beams are coming down and helping grow her fetus there. So that was last month, very positive card. For this month, the card that came up, again, it was in reverse, the Knight of Cups. So we got a knight here. We went from ace, the one, meaning we just, you know, we got to do the work right at the very beginning of the cup cycle, emotional healing cycle. Well, Knight is all the way towards the suits. He's the youngest of the suit cards. And so let me show you this card when it's not reversed. And here we have the romantic, our knight. He is a person who knows what he wants. Look, his eyes are fixed. He knows what he wants. His heart is wide open. Okay. He's still grounded. He's got that one foot on the ground. He's balanced. He's kind of in tree pose there on his stool. He's got flowers, wild horses, champagne, bubble bath. Notice how his cup is secured on the ground. Okay. He's not focusing on it like the ace was, but this is because he's ready to pour his love out. But this card came up in reverse. So maybe there's signs of new love that we're not being open enough to receive these signs. Maybe we have been repressing some of these negative emotions, or we have some unrealistic expectations that are blocking our progress. So that is what we want to help receive. We want to clear those blockages out so that none of these cards are in shadow. They're all being used here. So our overall message here from Tarot, when we go back to the the journal questions that we had, what is being culminated? If we focus on my heart is open and filled with love. Do you feel this since the winter solstice that your heart is feeling a whole lot more open and filled with love? Filled with love so that your cup, your inner landscape is overflowing, and then you move into being like the knight where you are the romantic and you're of service. Remember what this moon said, to do acts of service, to see the good around you, even if it's very small. When you do that, do you see how you will ascend like the woman in the world card? Okay. And by the way, we got a lot of balance here between, look at the way these cards, tarot always just amazes me. Look at the way these cards are. We have divine feminine here. Here she is on one side of the hands. And then here's our divine masculine on the other side. So again, when you have balance, you can see how, okay, then you're going to have that capacity for love. All right. So moving on here, now we're getting into the release part. And I'm just going to sort of, this is the same thing I like, again, with the ritual, the same kind of releasing. I really love the teachings of the serenity prayer, where we ask for serenity to whoever your spirit guides are, to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things that I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. So here you're welcome to do maybe two pieces of paper or separate pieces of paper if you wish. First of all, clearing out the old. What is it that you need to release in order to do the second part in with the new? Okay, to the do the be the knight who is receiving. So if you wanted to pause here and write and think about for releasing, you know, what is it that you feel that you need to surrender? If you're asking for serenity, then something's up, right? And you need to surrender to it. That's what this whole prayer is about. You know, spirit guides, you know, help me, kind of like cradle me through this process, just like that Ace of Cups card. What do you need courage with to help help you with right now? What do you need for acceptance? And then what can you gain wisdom on? So go ahead and think about those questions. Maybe when it's structured in a way like this, where it's fill in the blanks, maybe for you, for me, free writing in a journal is sometimes a challenge. That's why I need the tarot cards to sort of help me. But I find fill in the blank kind of questions like this a lot easier for the writing. Those of you need a journal prompt. Okay. Now, what is the new that we want to receive? So change the questions around. So in order to shine the light, what do I need to be aware of? So think about like the positives that are in your life. What do I need to be grateful for? Self-love, if you were going to focus on your cup and filling it, what are you going to do for your own self-love? And again, if you're surrendering, that means we got to have the trust in the first place. And then the inner strength, remember, when we have it, we can put our cup down like the knight, okay, and focus on, you know, giving to others, then we're going to find that we start to ascend. So asking for that inner strength. Okay, so you can pause that portion there. And after you've done this releasing, go ahead. If you still have your fire going, you can definitely burn those pieces of paper. If you love burning stuff, then you go for it. You do that, what feels good for you. And it'll actually feel really good when you release yourself of that energy that's weighing you down. It's good to cleanse yourself afterwards. And in the full moons, it's very nice after a ritual such as this to have a bath afterwards. New moon is often you have the bath before, so sort of open you up for purification, whereas in full moon is about kind of cleansing as you're doing the releasing. Okay, my window's open and the wind is picking up, it's blowing out my candles here. So when you're having your having, you know, indulging in pleasure, right, the joys, you can have a bath. And I would go ahead and have, here's what you can add to your bath. So using like the Epsom salts or Himalayan bath salts are really good for sort of increasing those positive vibes. Candles, again, remember those colors representing the sun colors, or crystals. If you want to add the crystals to your bath, go for it. Just make sure they're not of the salt type, like selenite, that's going to dissolve in the water. Okay. And what's really makes it pure decadent joy is to take your florals, you know, your ripened flowers, and put them right in the bath with you. Heck, even some of your strawberries if you wanted to. But it's really nice to have those florals in you. And then I want you, before you get into the bath, I want you to get your magic moon tea. So today, you know, if you want to try extra indulgence drinking, so not only are you taking the water, absorbing it on your outside landscape, you're also bringing it into your internal landscape as well. But you can go ahead and add some of this magic moon tea to your bath water, because I've had my dandelions boiling now for about 20 minutes, nice and strong medicines. You can put some of that into your bath water. And then as you're drinking, remember the meditation that we did where we surrounded ourselves with positive light. So we've cleared out the old, we're making way for the new, and we cleanse ourselves again of what no longer serves me, get it off, that energy off. I am a good person. I am. So these, say the following affirmations, every breath you take, you can say these. Okay, I ask to be free so that none of this negativity can touch me. As I cleanse, I do glow. As I cleanse from top to toe, you feel this peace within you. It washes over you and you feel a calmness ensue. I am whole. I am light. I am restored. I am a good person. I am enough. I love who I am. And so tonight we take from the teachings of the moon that there's the ripening, fertility all around us. And I encourage you to continue, before we close tonight, I encourage you to continue this surrendering to your heart, to, you know, the nature that abounds even after tonight's full moon. Get out there and connect your body to the land. Get out in nature. See all the plants that are wakening up, the fertility, the flowers, the fruits that are starting to ripen. Eat the fruits, smell the fruits, get it all over your skin. Like, celebrate what it means to be a living human being, okay, with the magic all around you. And then you can even take from nature and bring it inside. I love, if you come to my house, you can see I have animals on the wall, plants, driftwood, rocks. I love to bring the outdoors and have just as much as I possibly can in the indoors. So cooking with doing some kitchen magic. Let me just find my cursor here. There we go. Okay. Bring those into your cooking as well. And so I'm going to share a link. I'm going to try this. I'm hosting some guests this week, and I'm going to try this strawberry breakfast bake, which this particular recipe I'm going to use is going to be gluten-free, but you can use just regular oats for it. But, you know, using those strawberries into your cooking and continuing that mindful eating, not just from this one little moment, but bringing it into all of your meals throughout. That is self-care. Okay. And so before we kind of talk about our next month, remember that with community and holding space for each other, it means making a commitment to this moon magic. That it's like when you go to a yoga class, you can't just go to one class and then just, you know, how come I don't feel better? It doesn't work like that. It needs to be a journey. It is a process of kind of stripping those layers of the onion until you get to the core. So it's the same thing with the moons here. Okay, so I invite you before we close our ceremony that next month is a full buck moon in the month of July, that I welcome you to join us for that. I'll be making a video as well for that. And so let us close our four directions here, close our energy up, and we'll start kind of going in reverse here, closing the doors. We ended with the earth spirits when we opened. So let's start with them here when we close. And earth spirits, we offer our eternal thanks for joining us in our full moon circle. All our thoughts are on planting and growing and spending time with the earth. Bless us and bless all that we plant in the coming months. We bid you farewell. And in the West, water spirits, thank you for your presence tonight. But before we leave, we ask but one simple thing. Please grant us ample rain so that can nurture the delicate seedlings and herbs in their infancy as they grow towards the fruit. We bid you farewell. And the fire spirits, without your presence in the circle, our cleansing would not be possible. We continue to honor your light as we move towards the summer solstice, the heat and the ability to transform our lives. May we leave here tonight with eyes wide open to the possibilities of great things in our future. We bid you farewell. And our air spirits, so much gratitude and so much praise for your presence in our circle this night. The light winds on our faces constantly reminds us of the most powerful things are often unseen and unpredictable. Leave us with the understanding that we do not need to know why everything is the way it is. We just need to be thankful for it. We bid you farewell. And Creator, we thank you for your wisdom and love. We thank you, our spirit guides, for being with us. Go now and continue to be with us throughout our moon cycle. Together, we have shown that all things possess two sides, two energies, light and dark. And only together can total balance be achieved. Give us the guidance to look to all things in life with an even approach and an even mind. Grandmother Moon, full of abundance, we've rejoiced in your fullness tonight. As you sail on through the night, we follow you still. To you grow old in the night, and this cannot be seen in the sky anymore. Go if you must, but stay on if you will. Thank you for your blessings tonight, and may there be peace wherever your light shines on the earth. The circle is now open, but remains unbroken. Merry we meet, and merry we part, and merry we meet again. Blessings to you. Namaste.